Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. So I was planning to make an unboxing video for my new telescope, the Celestron Evolution 8. And it's come in a very large box. You can probably just about see it here on the floor. In fact, it came in many boxes within a large box. So that's all pretty standard. Unfortunately, this one hasn't got very far in terms of an unboxing, in as much as there's some damage to the corrector plate, basically straight out of the box. So I'm just gonna show you what I'm talking about. Hopefully you can pick it up. So this is, you can see there are some, there's a sort of scratch, certainly an absence of the coatings on the front of the corrector. And there's quite a lot of bits and pieces of other items. I think it's either scratches or just certainly marks on the inside of the corrector. Quite a few flecks as well, here and there on the lower part of the corrector. So basically, this one is going to go back to the supplier and we'll see what they make of it. A few other things worth noting, straight out of the box, there's a few what I'll call scuffs here on top of the tube, on top of the mount. And there's a few places where, well, the fitting's not exactly great. It doesn't look so good, but isn't likely to have any effect on the overall performance of the scope. But basically, for the price of this scope, probably expected a little bit more quality control. Okay, so fast forward a couple of weeks, I decided to send that scope back to the suppliers, First Light Optics. They had a look at it and then they ordered me a replacement. So here it is. This one comes with a new sticker, was certainly new to me. Clear skies guaranteed eventually, which is, I quite like that as an update to their normal sticker. So, okay, let's open it up and see how this one compares. Okay, so worth mentioning that when you get the box, it's about 26 kilos. So it's not really too heavy. You'll be able to drag it around. It's more that it's a bulky item. Opening the second scope up immediately looks a lot cleaner. It looks like a new scope with no scuffs and marks. And the optical bit, the bit that we worry about the most, also looks a lot better. So thanks to First Light Optics for turning around the replacement scope. Hopefully this one is going to be a good performer, but I'll let you know in future videos. So what actually is inside the box? Well, not too many pieces, fortunately. It's basically you have the tripod, the mount, single fork mount, and the optical tube assembly. So three big boxes of substantial stuff, and then a whole load of accessories. So you have a red dot finder, which obviously you need to align straight away with the optical tube if you're going to use it effectively. This one is nice and clean, which is good. And then the small boxes, well, what do you get? Well, you get an instruction booklet, which I guess could be pretty useful, tells you the basic setup. You get another one linked to the hand controller. It comes with a hand controller, even though you can obviously use this scope with Wi-Fi to an app on your phone or your tablet. This is the Nexstar Plus hand controller, which has a USB port on it and maybe slightly different version to the one that originally came with the scope. There are two eyepieces. You've got a 40mm plossel and a 13mm plossel. You've got an AC power adapter. This scope charges its own lithium battery on board, and I charged it up last night and it took about 6 hours to the point when the logo, the charging light, became steady and I knew that it was fully charged. So we'll see how that works out. Obviously, one of the big attractions of the Evo range is that you can use it hands-free, as it were. You don't need any wires to power packs. Other than that, standard 1.25 diagonal and a mounting bracket if you want to put the hand controller onto the side of the tripod leg. So I'm going to try and use it initially with my phone and the Sky Portal app and see if that works out. If not, maybe go to the hand controller and experiment with that. So, okay, hope it's been useful. Pretty short video, bit of a hiccup. Fingers crossed, second version of this scope is a good one, and I'll let you know in future videos. hopefully it's been interesting, and you can subscribe to Jenham's Astro if you push the button, and look out for more astro videos from my channel. Thanks for watching.